चलिए, टू थ्री क्वेश्चंस आर लेफ्ट फ्रॉम एक्सरसाइज 10.5, सो सॉरी 10.5 ही चल रही है. सो लेट अस कंटिन्यू एक्सरसाइज 10.5, क्वेश्चन नंबर 11. क्वेश्चन नंबर 11. टेंथ वी हैव फिनिश्ड यस्टरडे, इलेवेंथ क्वेश्चन वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट. एबीसी एंड एडीसी आर टू राइट एंगल्स विद कॉमन हाइपोटेन्यूज एसी. अगेन दिस इज अ क्वेश्चन इन विच फिगर इज नॉट गिवन, सो वी हैव टू मेक अ फिगर फर्स्ट, राइट? सो व्हाट यू नीड टू डू हियर, right angles triangles are to form having the common hypotenuse AC. So that's why first of all I'm making the hypotenuse AC. On one side, right angle triangle ABC I'm drawing, and on another side, right angle triangle ADC I'm drawing. This is the way to draw this figure, that firstly make the common hypotenuse AC and then make one right angle triangle ABC below it and another right angle triangle ADC above it. So what he says, if it is like this, prove that angle CAD is equal to angle CBD. देखिए जरा, CAD and CBD, can we see them in the question, in the figure? CAD very much visible. Next is CBD. So let us firstly write given two right angled triangles. इसको शॉर्ट फॉर्म कहते हैं, आर टी डॉट राइट एंगल डी. राइट एंगल्ड ट्राइंगल्स, ट्राइंगल एबीसी एंड ट्राइंगल एडीसी विद कॉमन हाइपोटेन्यूज एसी टू प्रूव एंगल सीएडी इक्वल टू एंगल सीबीडी. We want to prove angle CAD is equal to angle CBD. Right? Let us start with the proof. See, we want to prove CAD to be equal to CBD. That means this angle CAD, this is to be proved to be equal to CBD. ये दोनों एंगल्स हमें इक्वल प्रूव कर. इफ आई कंसिडर दिस कोड सी डी ऑफ द सर्कल, अगर मैं, सर्कल तो है ही नहीं वैसे, दिस इज वट आई वॉन्ट टू कन्वे कि यहाँ पे सर्कल नहीं है हमारे पास, बट अगर फिर भी हम देखें, हम इसको अगर कोड माने, सी डी कोड अगर हम माने, मान लो इसके अराउंड पे सर्कल हो, हम एक, मैं एक सर्कल रफली सा यहाँ पे बना लेती हूँ लाइट से कलर का. अगर इसके अराउंड एक सर्कल हो, होप सो, देन सी डी विल कैन बी रिगार्डेड एज द कोड ऑफ द सर्कल. सी डी को हम सर्कल की कोड कह सकते हैं. एंड दिस कोड इज डिवाइडिंग द सर्कल इनटू टू सेगमेंट्स, वन सेगमेंट अबव दिस कोड, अनदर सेगमेंट बिलो द कोड. वन सेगमेंट अबव द कोड, अनदर सेगमेंट बिलो द कोड. देन very easily we can say that this is one of the segment of the circle in which point B and A lie, and this chord CD, it is making angle CBD and CAD in the same segment of the circle. And we know that angles made by the chord in the same segment, they are always equal. So which follows the result that angle CBD is equal to angle CAD. Now the thing is, इसके अराउंड अगर सर्कल नहीं है तो कहां से लेके आए इसके अराउंड सर्कल? कंस्ट्रक्ट तो करने से रहे, So what we should do so that the circle should be there around this figure, this quadrilateral. We should prove that ABCD is a cyclic quadrilateral. If ABCD will be cyclic quadrilateral, then naturally this will become chord and these two angles, they will become angles in the same segment. And with that reason, we can tell them to be equal. Hum unko equal bol sakte hain us reason ke saath. Now our target is to prove this to be the kya? Cyclic quadrilateral. Chaliye, let us start with the proof. First of all, see angle ABC, this is equal to 90 degree as triangle ABC is a right angled triangle. As triangle ABC is a right angled triangle, so angle ABC is equal to 90 degree. Similarly, angle ADC is equal to 90 degree. Isko one keh do, isko two keh do. Reason likho, as triangle ADC is a right angled triangle. Is a right angle triangle. So we can use 90 degree angle like this. Adding these two, adding one and two, you will be having angle ABC plus angle ADC. This is equal to 90 plus 90. So angle ABC plus angle ADC, this is equal to 180 degree. ABC plus ADC, this is equal to 180 degree. When ABC and ADC, their sum comes out to be 180 degree, what it means? Sum of the opposite angles of this quadrilateral, it comes out to be 180 degree. So we know the characteristic, the property of the cyclic quadrilateral, that if in a cyclic quadrilateral, sum of the opposite angles comes out to be 180 degree, then that is going to be a cyclic quadrilateral. Right? So same thing I'm writing. This implies sum of opposite angles of ABCD is 180 degree. This implies sum of opposite angles of ABCD is 180 degree. So this implies ABCD is a cyclic quadrilateral. ABCD is a cyclic quadrilateral. So we prove that ABCD is a cyclic quadrilateral. So if it is a cyclic quadrilateral, we can consider the chord CD of the circle. Now I'm writing. Consider the chord. Consider the chord CD of the cyclic quadrilateral. Of the cyclic quadrilateral ABCD. Here, therefore, angle CBD is equal to angle CAD. Ek line ka proof hai. Isko cyclic proof kar do. Immediately you will get CBD equal to CAD. Mentioning the reason aside, because angles made by a chord in angles made by a chord in same segment are equal. So we are giving the reason that why we are taking these two angles to be equal, because we have proved that ABCD is a cyclic quadrilateral, CD being the chord will construct, will you can say make the same angles in the same segment. So this follows the result, hence proved. Right? So this is all about question number 11. Now we are going to start with 12th question. Question number 12. Question number 12. Prove that cyclic parallelogram is a rectangle. Prove that if a parallelogram is cyclic, then it is going to be a rectangle. Let us firstly try to understand the question with the help of the figure. Cyclic parallelogram. So ABCD is having two qualities here. One, it is cyclic, that means it is inscribed in a circle. Another, it is parallelogram. So two qualities of ABCD are given to us. One is that it is cyclic quadrilateral. And moreover, it is given, it is a parallelogram. And we need to prove that it is a rectangle. So statement is clear to you, I think, with the help of the figure. So let us write down given a cyclic quadrilateral ABCD was a cyclic parallelogram ABCD. Cyclic parallelogram ABCD is given to us. We want to prove ABCD is a rectangle. To prove ABCD is a rectangle. Let us start with the proof. ABCD is a rectangle. Parallelogram ko agar rectangle prove karna ho na, it is sufficient to prove that its one angle is 90 degree. If you are able to prove its one angle to be 90 degree, then immediately parallelogram will turn into a rectangle. So that means indirectly in this question, we will prove that at least one of these four angles going to be 90 degree, then it will become a rectangle. Right? Do cheeze jo humare paas given hai, one, it is cyclic. Another, it is a parallelogram, will help us to reach the required result. So firstly, I'm using as ABCD is a cyclic quadrilateral hai. This implies angle A plus angle C is 180 degree, equation number one. We know that sum of opposite pair of angles, this is equal to 180 degree in case of cyclic quadrilateral. Cyclic quadrilateral ke case mein opposite angles ka jo sum hai, that we are having it to be 180 degree. So we can write A plus C to be 180 degree. Now the next thing is, second thing that is given to us as ABCD is a parallelogram. Dono cheeze hum use kar lenge. Pehle humne cyclic quadrilateral, ab parallelogram. As ABCD is a parallelogram, so being parallelogram, its opposite angles will be equal. This implies angle A is equal to angle C. Equation number two, write the reason. Because opposite angles of a parallelogram are equal. Opposite angles of a parallelogram are equal. Right? Now, from one using two. Equation number one, A plus C, 180 degree. यूजिंग टू रिप्लेस वन एंगल बाय द अनदर, सी की जगह पे ए लिख दो एंगल ए प्लस ए 180 डिग्री. दिस इंप्लाइज टू एंगल ए 180 डिग्री, टू एंगल ए इक्वल टू 180 डिग्री एंड दिस इंप्लाइज एंगल ए इज इक्वल टू 180 अपॉन टू दैट इज 90 डिग्री. So you will conclude therefore ABCD is a parallelogram with one angle as 90 degree, with one angle as 90 degree. So this implies ABCD is a rectangle. ABCD is a rectangle. Therefore, cyclic parallelogram is a rectangle. अगर एक पैरेललोग्राम साइक्लिक है देन इट विल डेफिनेटली गोइंग टू बी अ रेक्टेंगल एंड दैट वी हैव प्रूव्ड हेंस प्रूव्ड. दिस इज ऑल अबाउट विद दिस एक्सरसाइज राइट. सो एज फॉर एज वन पीडीएफ आई सेंड टू योर ग्रुप व्हिच इज टेलिंग यू द सिलेबस ऑफ टर्म टू एंड एज फॉर एज सिलेबस ऑफ टर्म टू इज कंसर्न्ड वी ऑल नो इट कंसिस्ट ऑफ पॉलीनोमियल्स एंड देन quadrilaterals, then circles, then constructions, then surface area volumes, then probability, right? So these will be the chapter that you are going to see in your final exam, that is your term 2, right? So with this question, we have finished the syllabus. But some examples of chapter 10th, they are still to be discussed. So firstly, let us discuss the examples of chapter 10th. Then we will make the schedule that how to do the revision in order, which chapter and that. Everything we'll discuss afterwards. So firstly, I am taking up the examples of exercise 10.5. Examples of 10.5. First of all, let us see the third example, page number 183. 183 page, example number 3. Let us see. We are given a circle in which AB is given to be the diameter of the circle. So one circle, center O, diameter AB. AB is given to be the diameter of the circle. थोड़ा नीचे बनाते हैं फिगर, ऊपर की तरफ इसको एक्सटेंड करना है हमें. जस्ट अ मिनट वेट. AB, diameter of the circle passing through the center of the circle. CD is a chord of a circle. CD is given to be the chord of the circle like this. CD is the chord of the circle equal to the radius of the circle. This chord of CD, this is given that its length is equal to the radius of the circle. Chord CD, its length is given to be equal to the radius of the circle. AC and BD, when extended, intersect at point E. AC and BD when extended meeting at point E. जब हम AC और BD को extend करते हैं, they are meeting at the point E. E point पे वो meet करते हैं. Prove that angle AEB, this is 60 degree. We want to prove that angle AEB, this is its value is 60 degree. In RD also this question is given, RD Sharma book, this question is given. In that question, it is told find angle AEB. वहाँ पे आपको angle AEB find करना है. तो वहाँ पे आप देखोगे solution में AEB का answer आपका 60 degree आता है. और यहाँ पे he is saying prove that angle AEB is 60 degree. So in both ways question can be asked. It can be asked that prove that AEB is equal to 60 degree and it can be asked in this way that find angle AEB. So in that case your AEB should come out to be 60 degree. Right? चलिए. So सबसे पहले हम given गुवन जो कुछ भी लिखना है वो लिखते हैं. So given. A circle with center O, diameter AB, chord AC, CD, and ACBD meeting at E on extending AC and BD, they are meeting at the point E. This is given to us, but we want to prove angle AEB is equal to 60 degree. हम ये prove करना चाहते हैं that हमारा angle AEB जो है उसका answer 60 degree आए. चलिए proof शुरू करते हैं. You see this angle AEB. If I ask you that this angle AEB, in which triangle it will lie, obviously your answer will be triangle AEB. But I would like to shorten that triangle. If this is triangle, it lies in triangle AEB. I can also say that this lies in triangle CED. ये ट्राइंगल सीईडी में लाई करता है बिकॉज जो वैल्यू सीईडी की होगी वही हमारी वैल्यू वी कैन टेक इट वी कैन कंसीडर इट टू बी ऑफ एईबी. सो माय टारगेट इज टू फाइंड सीईडी व्हिच इज सेम एज एंगल एईबी. अगर सीईडी 60 आता है तो वी कैन से दैट एईबी इज 60 डिग्री. Rather, he is taking it the part of triangle BCE. इसके पीछे भी एक रीजन है. ओके. उसने क्या किया है वो एक कंस्ट्रक्शन अभी मैं बताती हूँ कि रीजन क्या है इसका. दिस इज डी. वो इस सी मैंने एंगल सीईडी लिया है ना, वो इसको मान रहा है एंगल सीईबी. उसने सीडी को ज्वाइन कर दिया. ये कंस्ट्रक्शन ये की पॉइंट है, मिस हो जाएगा. जैसे मुझे भी थोड़ा सा ये भूला कि ये इस ट्रायंगल में हमने इसमें जाना है. सो विल से ज्वाइन बीसी. अभी बताती हूँ कि ये क्यों ऐसे क्यों है ज्वाइन बीसी. नाउ आई कैन से दैट माई एंगल एईबी इज नथिंग बट एंगल सीईबी. जो एंगल सीईबी अगर आ गया 60 आता है तो मैं कह सकती हूँ कि मेरा AEB जो है वो 60 है. सो माई टारगेट इज टू फाइंड दिस एंगल CEB. ये एंगल CEB मुझे फाइंड करना है. अब अगर मुझे आई वॉन्ट टू फाइंड दिस एंगल CEB, माई टारगेट शुड बी टू फाइंड दीज टू एंगल्स. मैं इधर लेके आती हूँ इसको. CEB में इफ आई वॉन्ट टू फाइंड दिस एंगल, the rest of two angles should be known to me. ठीक है, rest of two angles they should be known to me. यानी कि ये वाला एंगल और ये वाला एंगल मुझे पता होने चाहिए, तभी मैं एंगल सीईबी जो है वो फाइंड कर सकती हूँ. So my target is firstly to find these two angles. इन दोनों एंगल्स को फाइंड करना जरूरी है टू फाइंड एंगल सीईबी. तो मेरा टारगेट इन दोनों को फाइंड करने का है सबसे पहले. तो यू कैन सी फर्स्टली आई एम फाइंडिंग दिस एंगल सी एंड दिस इज मेकिंग लीनियर पेयर विद दिस एसीबी एंड यू नो बेटर दैट एसीबी इज द एंगल इन द सेमी सर्कल बीइंग एबी एज डायामीटर. आई एम टेकिंग एबी एज डायामीटर. If I take AB to be the diameter, then in this angle ACB is the angle in the semicircle. So I'm writing here angle ACB, this is equal to 90 degree angle in the semicircle. ACB 90 degree angle in the semicircle. So now we can use linear pair of this angle ECB, which is my target, with ACB. ACB plus ECB, this is 180 degree linear pair. So this is 90. Important hai ye example. ECB, this is equal to 180. Difficult bhi hai thodi si. So ECB, this is equal to 180 minus 90. So angle ECB, this comes out to be 90. ये एंगल आ गया. अब किसी तरह से इसको भी ढूंढ ले तो हमारा टारगेट इस ट्राइंगल में जाके एंगल सम प्रॉपर्टी लगा के अचीव हो सकता है. सो नाउ माय टारगेट इज टू फाइंड दिस एंगल. ये वाला एंगल, इस एंगल को हम फाइंड करेंगे. देखिए कैसे. चलिए आपको पता है हमने डिग्री मेयर थ्योरम की थी एंड आई टोल्ड यू डिग्री मेयर थ्योरम इट्स नेम इज सजेस्टिंग दैट इट इज यूज्ड इन फाइंडिंग द डिग्री ऑफ एन एंगल. इस एंगल को मेयर करने के लिए द थ्योरम इज यूज्ड नोन एज डिग्री मेयर थ्योरम. सो टू मेयर दिस एंगल आई विल अप्लाई डिग्री मेयर थ्योरम विद विच आर्क. लेट मी टेल यू आई एम कंसिडरिंग दिस वो वाला आर्क कंसिडर करो जिसका सेंटर का एंगल आपको पता हो. So if I consider this arc CD of the circle, ये arc जो CD है circle का, तो इस arc CD का center का angle अगर मुझे देखना है, we know that how to see the angle of an arc at the particular point. If I want to see the angle of this arc CD at center, what I need to do, I have to approach the end points of CD to the center O. So I'm approaching it C O D. So this arc CD at center it is making angle COD. ठीक है. और remaining part of the circle पे बहुत सारे points हैं. ये है remaining part of the circle CD arc को छोड़ के. तो इसपे बहुत सारे point हैं. One of the point on this remaining part of the circle is this point B. This point B. And we can find angle CBD, which is also made by the same arc starting with C, going to B, coming back to D. Same arc is extended, subtending angle CBD at a point B, which lies on the remaining part of the circle. So with these two angles, one at the center, one at the remaining part of the circle, we can go for degree Meyer theorem to find CBD. But the question is, one of this should known to us. Are we in condition that we are knowing COD? Yes, one given is there which will help us to find COD. See, we are given this code is equal to the radius of the circle. Ye given humne ek bar bhi use nahi kiya. Given hai that code CD, this is equal to the radius of the circle. Radius is CO and OD, both are the radius. So this is this implies triangle COD is an equilateral triangle. Equilateral triangle. So this implies angle COD is equal to 60 degree. Triangle COD is an equilateral triangle. Therefore, angle COD is equal to 60 degree. This is very much clear. Okay, 60 degree ho gaya. Now, to this COD and to this CBD, we can apply degree Mayer theorem. We'll write, consider arc CD of the circle. Minor arc hai. So angle subtended by an arc at the center, that means COD, is angle subtending by an arc at the center is double the angle subtended by the same arc at the point on the remaining part of the circle that I'm taking CBD, which is my target. ये सारा कुछ CBD को find करने के चक्कर में हो रहा है. So this is 60. Why so? Because each angle of equilateral triangle is 60 degree. We already explained. So this is 60 by 2 angle CBD. So angle CBD, it comes out to be 30 degree. CBD की value हमारे पास 30 degree आ गई. And when this CBD come out to be 30 degree, you proceed in angles in triangle CEB. So in triangle CEB, one angle we have find 90, another angle we have find 30, and the last angle is CEB, which is to be find out 180. 120 उधर जाएगा, minus हो जाएगा. CEB is 180 minus 120. So angle CEB, this is equal to 60 degree. And so is AEB. जो हमारी CEB की value आई है 60 degree, I can say this is AEB. So because angle is identified from the center letter, not from the side letter. So side letters can be changed and center letter will remain the same. No difference will be there in the measure. So this implies angle AEB, this is equal to 60 degree. And it's brought. देखने में मुश्किल लगता है, पर अगर इसको आप एक सीक्वेंस में लेके चलोगे तो कुछ मुश्किल नहीं है. मैंने क्या किया, नथिंग आई एम डूइंग, आई एम जस्ट मेकिंग वन कोड बीसी व्हिच इज गोइंग टू बी द, यू कैन से, की पॉइंट ऑफ द सॉल्यूशन. एंड बीसी कोड बनने के बाद आई एम हैविंग अ ट्राइंगल बीसीई इन विच माई टारगेट लाइज. टू फाइंड दिस टारगेट, टू अचीव दिस टारगेट, आई शुड नो द अदर टू एंगल्स, दिस एंगल एंड दिस एंगल. This angle I am finding by using linear pair with a semicircle 90 degree angle. So very easily this angle will be found out. But this angle, ये वाला angle find करना ही थोड़ी सी हमारी जो है मुशक्कत वाला काम है. So we are applying degree Mayer theorem with the help of this arc, you can say CD. This arc CD is subtending angle COD at the center and CBD at the remaining part of the circle. Applying degree Mayer theorem to this. This is 60 degree because being equilateral triangle, so you're getting CBD to be 30 degree. Then apply angle sum property to reach the required results. We'll continue tomorrow. So 9C, do send your holidays homework today positive.